Okay. Getting close? Three caves went through. Turned it off. No, I hit W. We are supposed to go down this way. I want to speed up again. Let's get to the end. Let's see if there's anything interesting in this house. Oh, if we duck under it. What's that sound? The birds? I hear it. It almost sounds like people whispering. I can't see anyone or anything in there. That's creepy though. Oh, am I supposed to jump? I'm supposed to jump across again.
I have to jump across.
Yes. Yes, you do. Ah! Damn you. Three caves. Three platformings. Yeah, this is... the longer and more trying way. That same one I fell. I will kill the world. The entire world. One person at a time. I know it'll take a while. Can I just... oh, there's words. Let me read the words. Kind of glad I didn't make it. You used to make funny sounds while we were laying on the carpet. Yeah, I remember this line too. For no reason would his love end by the line drawn by your certain death. You have to keep on climbing up the mountain of fire. Despite all the lies and curses, there will be no more witchery curses around the neighborhood for 4 years. This is the reason why she will burn in your love until the end of time. Say no more. Just say no more. I miss the old melodies, especially the one that opened our journey. Play it, and I will remain silent. Speaking of remaining silent, you're getting loud with the music. It's really not necessary. I can hear it just fine. There's no need to get the... oh, you're kidding me. Why is that one so impossible? Do I have to stand somewhere else on this? Ah, made it. I wish I could, like, quick save right now or something. This one is a little further apart. It has to be. It's a little trickier than the others. No. Wee. It's the second to last one. I mean, it's the last stone, but then I have to jump across to the ledge, it looks like. Oh my god. Really? Do not let your anger overcome you. Okay, my anger's overcoming me. Should I jump from this? Or does it even matter? Oh my god, I almost fell at the... I went to where I almost fell and jumped. And still didn't make it. So maybe not from that. Because that happened to me before, where it looked like... the rock was jutting out, where I could, like, jump easier, and it wasn't that way. I almost didn't make that, too. Okay, so just jump from here. Ah! See, somehow I make that. We're not sticking out further. Well, you can't see it from here. Please don't fall here. Thank you. I made it. Over the crusty old donut of doom. Another cave. Good god. Oh. I don't know if I want to go in the water. Oh, what is that? Oh. I was teleported. Blood. The blood of the ancients. Okay. Close to the end? I don't keep saying that. It sounds like the end. Does that sound like a nice end song? Oh, we're starting to see some snow. Wait. Hold up. No, don't do that to me. No! Ugh. I made it, okay. Don't, turn it off. Stupid auto-run. I mean, once you press a key, it should turn itself off automatically. I wanted to look over there. There's nothing really to see. So I did all that for nothing. Okay. The crystals of Arborea. That's a game for the Amiga.
What is it I have seen? A fever dream?
Hell if I know, lady.
Fragments of memory? But they are not my memories. They are the memories of a people doomed. I saw the end of their world, their sky broken, not in apocalyptic striations, but in a slow burning. Their end was hard and bitter agony, a long drawn out whimpering of life. They held out hope until the very last. Hope that it wasn't true. Hope for something better to come.
But their hope was in vain, and they died in agony. And we still have to go all this way, because I see that dragon way over there.
I saw fields of corpses, flags planted in the ground and burning.
Damn it.
I saw millions gathered at a black stone, like ants, on their knees, while the world burned around them. They did nothing but hope. I had always thought that hope was a good thing, but it blinded them to the truth. I saw a young mother looking up to the sky, shielding her infant from the sun. Her tears were the only water I saw.
Yeah, those pictures kind of get in the way. I can't see. Sparkly things.
After the burning came winter. An eternal winter that locked the remaining life in its grip. All fell silent. A great hush was cast upon all that had passed before. Their world became a frozen tomb. There were none to witness the snow's fall. None to catch the gleam of light prismed through a single snowflake. None to hum a sad tune for the fallen. None to ever witness beauty again, though beauty remained. The thought makes me weep.
What is that? Give me that thought. Give me the thought of what that is. You are getting quite high,
there
finally.
There is no greater love than to be remembered. It is the least I can do. It is the closest we may come to immortality. Perhaps that is what they sought. Simply to never end. I can't blame them. The fear of death is great. Fear of the great unknown. Fear that the end is just the end of awareness and all sensation. Possible to imagine the absence of imagination.
Oh, yeah, that one.
And so, we tend to imagine something there, something beyond all ending.
Indeed, huh? There's Red Mountain of Vardenfell. That's the genie, I think. Getting close. Those were these two mountains, and you can walk between them. One of them had a woman with blue hair and a guy just sitting there.
I have traveled far along this path and begin to despair that it will ever end. What is the genie? I started with joy in my heart and reverence for spring, but now the cold terror and numb beauty of winter grips me. Spring seems impossible and feeble in comparison. Branches bare as bony hands are dull reminders of a season stirring deep in the blood. This is the time of longing, the stark contrast of white on white.
That's very twinkly and purple. Yeah, so we got, like, I think it's... Is it that mountain? Well, it's the top there, but we can walk between them, I guess, down along there. Yeah, one had the lady, the girl with the blue hair, and the guy sitting there, and then you went across and you saw the wizard, which is the good wizard, not the evil one, because you got there before him, and the genie. Look at this. There's that statue again.
Madness of perfect and complete nothing. The truth is, winter never leaves us. It lives on in the damp, stony soil of spring's crippled rising. She is asleep in the dark roots, tremulous fingers that grope for the mystery of unknown warmth. She can make no promises of her return, though she sings in my blood like rain. It is winter, and we are only waiting.
Okie dokie. You do your waiting then. Oh, I can't go that way. Okay. Invisible barrier. There we go, to the top of that mountain. Someone standing there? Oh, it could be a statue. Could be the girl with the blue hair again. It's Chloe Price.
I have become a study of pale shades riddled into the frost. A scrying of ice on a brittle window. These are the days of extreme white, in bone-chilling blasts of frozen dawn. The sky itself groans in cyclopean cloud banks of funerary marble. Through the driven winds and ruptured stone, through this desolate failing of whirling winter, I feel the cold loneliness of the world. I cup my hands over my steaming mouth and try not to cry.
Really upset by all that, aren't you? Well, there's the whatever that is over there. Well, there's another one of those weird things. I don't know what that is. Oh, wow. Is that... Those are clouds, you know? I thought that was the ocean. Above the clouds. Yeah, those weird things.
I started this path with such hope in my heart, and now I feel only despair. What good is hope when life is full of heartache and loss? None may feel our joys or sorrows. We are truly alone in the world. What is the point of it all? It seems so senseless. I never asked to be alive, cast into life against my will, without a choice. It is a curse. My bare feet are bloodied and bruised from this journey.
Bare feet? What?
My only hope left is that it will soon end.
Why are you walking with bare feet? My God, you'd be frostbitten too with this snow. That's pretty stupid. You never heard of shoes? I mean, your ex-boyfriend was a shoemaker. Surely he could have lent you some shoes or something. Just take a peek.
No answers along the path, only more questions. What is the genie? What does it do?
Who
made it, and where is it from? I shall soon find out. Perhaps it will answer all my questions. I have considered that it may pose more questions than answers, and feel that somehow I already know the answers. And now I see.
It's a computational device, Dad said. Oh, there it is.
There is no genie.
Oh.
Instead, I see the wizard that spoke to me in my dreams. As I draw nearer, I can hear his voice again. That strange sound with unmoving lips that I can understand as words. Lula, he said, you have made it to the Mountain of Fire. Unfortunately, you have chosen to avoid your fears along the longest path. You have learned that there are no answers in this choice.
Oh, wow.
In avoiding the darkness of your mind, you have succumbed to it. You, who started this journey with infinite potentiality, have since lost all hope. The path you have chosen is the longest path, and so the other wizard has preceded you here. He has taken the genie, and even now is at work to end this program. You will never walk again. Your mother, father, and Rofesso will cease to be, and the world as you know it will be gone forever.
Well, that stinks.
Program, I wondered. I don't understand. I began to cry. What is the genie? I needed to know. The genie, he explained, is a computational construct, what we call a processor. As an operating administrator, I have introduced a packet of data into the genie. It arranges the data into information that runs a program. This program is called Lula. Your first moment of being was just before you chose the path. You see, Lula, he continued, this world and everything in it, all your memories and dreams, your mother and father, have all been created by you. You have arranged the data into a stream of consciousness that seems real to you. The other wizard, as you think of it, is a bug in the system. Since you chose the longest path, he has had time to corrupt the data, and so now the program must end. Without hope for this world, you are incapable of verifying the data. Thank you for this learning experience. The grass bracelet my father made came unbound from my wrist and fell to the ground. I saw all the world fading before me, the memory of my mother and father slipping away. Myself, a light dimming in the darkness and flickering out. Sorrow overwhelmed me as the wizard said, goodbye, Lula. Terminating function. End program. Then, silence. Nothingness gaped before me. My final thought, regret. I would have had a story to tell. It would have begun. Once upon a time.
So yeah, now I wish I played the red one last. If I play the blue one and then the red one. Because the red one has the good ending. Who would have known, though? It's just an arbitrary choice. I don't think you even know when you see the boat, the two paths, you can even tell which one's the longest one. Well, that was interesting. What do you guys think? A bit long, I think, all things considered. But it was interesting. Hope you guys enjoyed. I really enjoyed the music. Voice acting was alright, I guess. There's a few interesting parts. Could have had some more interactivity thrown in. Definitely. You're welcome for playing. But did you try the other path? Yes, I did. Yes, it is different. It's better. Take the red pill, guys. Take the red pill. Ride the dragon? Wait a second. Ride the dragon.
Ta-da! Oh.
I almost didn't see that.
There we go.
Ha ha ha. Cool music for it, too. It's like no control, though. I mean, I can look around, but we can't control the dragon, make it go faster or slower, apparently. Tail's on fire. Or is it breathing fire out of its mouth and it's flaming behind it? Oh. I know what that means. There was a flash there. Wait, I am? Was I turning it? Wait. See that? A flash, like that. I'm not sure, because I'm turning and it's not turning. Unless it's just really slow like that. Oh, there's the... The blue-haired lady, the blue-haired girl. Oh, there's that house. We gotta get a better look at it. What does that mean? It's like the dragon's getting hurt or something. But if that's the case, I don't know what I can do to make it not get hurt. Maybe I'm supposed to keep pressing forward or something? What else are we gonna visit? I thought there was another one next to me. It sounded... See, I was pressing forward and that happened. I don't know if that's what that means. If anything. Whee! Oh, I'm gonna visit the statue? Oh, that's not a statue. Never mind. just has this house in the middle of nowhere. I didn't want to get off there. Cool song. That. Back towards the beginning, I think we're going. You running out of steam, big guy? Fading out. What a world, what a world. Okay, now I think we're done. Okay, Ride the Dragon. Pretty cool. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in another Let's Play. Maybe another Drizzlepath, or maybe... really bored by this, and I couldn't really blame you. Maybe in a game with a little more interactivity and such. I'm fine as long as you're there with me somewhere, somehow. Thanks for watching, guys. See you next time. Bye, Dragon. And always, seek adventure.